In this problem, we're being asked to verify this trig identity. Let's go ahead and go through it. So, solution. So, when verifying trig identities, we have to pick a side to start with. So, we have a choice. We can start with the left-hand side, or we can start with the right-hand side. So, I'm looking at this, and I haven't done it yet, but I think in this case, it might be better to start with the right-hand side because there's a plus sign here. And that will actually allow us to do something, like we can perform the addition and then hope everything goes well. Whereas if we start with this side, I feel like it might be a little bit harder to do anything with this. So let's start by writing down the right-hand side. So this is 1 plus tan squared x. Okay, and this is equal to. And so the goal is to get to this side here. So what I'm thinking is we can write tangent in terms of sine and cosine, and then perform the addition. So this is really 1 plus, well, tangent is sine over cosine, so tangent squared will be sine squared x over cosine squared x. So now, in order to perform the addition, the 1 has to be written as a fraction where cosine squared is the denominator. To do that, we can write it as cosine squared x over cosine squared x. And that's being added to sine squared x over cosine squared x. Right, that's the same thing as 1. And now we can perform the addition here. So this is equal to cosine squared x plus sine squared x over, it's all over, cosine squared x. And cosine squared plus sine squared is a famous identity. It's equal to 1. And this is over cosine squared. But let's pause here for a moment, right? Where are we going? We're trying to get to 1 minus sine squared. Well, cosine squared is equal to 1 minus sine squared. And that completes the problem. So I have this memorized. Cosine squared is equal to 1 minus the other one squared. Likewise, sine squared is equal to 1 minus the other one squared. These are worth memorizing, I think. They come up enough to where it's worth it, you know. You can memorize this one too, cosine squared plus sine squared equals 1. And then you can use this one to come up with these, right? Like to come up with the first one, you subtract sine squared. To come up with the second one, you take this equation and you subtract cosine squared. But at some point, you get really tired of going through that, and then you just memorize them. And again, the best way, or the way I do it at least, is cosine squared is 1 minus the other one squared. Sine squared is 1 minus the other 1 squared. Really, really useful, and it saves you a lot of time and problems. So, nice problem. I hope this video has been helpful. Good luck.